you know, we've seen how President Obama developed from, first of all, containing, then degrading, and now I think we reached a stage of demolishing and eradicating. I think that with each killing that takes place, unfortunately, every time, hopefully the world community will be more united in really in eradicating this this disease that's really infecting the whole Middle Eastern region, that and inevitably will be contagious to other countries in the world.
Saudi Arabia held exercises earlier this year with 130,000 troops. Is it a fair assessment to say they want a very strong response by the kingdom here? And would Saudi Arabia put troops on the ground, do you think?
No, I think that Saudi Arabia would not be involved directly in fighting the ISIS in Iraq or Syria, because really this does not really affect, although it affected implicitly, it does not really affect Saudi Arabia explicitly. But clearly this military maneuvers that took place a few months ago, it's a multifaceted message. It's a message to Iran, number one, is that we're going to defend our territory and defend the GCC countries, number one. Number two, it's a message also to the ISIS group in Iraq, and also a message to the southern border. So there's a big vacuum in the Arab world. So clearly military power is a very important message to the whole world, because this could be translated eventually into political power.
A mistrust with Washington and a mistrust with President Obama. Do they not trust him after the Arab Spring and what's transpired in Syria, Egypt, and even Libya?
I think when Obama took over, expectations were raised substantially, dramatically in the Arab world, the Muslim world. But clearly what took place, you know, by having this rapprochement with Iran without really informing the Arab world, especially Saudi Arabia, by putting red line against Syria, using chemical weapons, and having Syria use chemical weapons, and still he blinked when Russia exerted pressure on him, and his late reply on ISIS took him more than 2 months to assemble this the team of Arab 10 Arab countries and Turkey to really face ISIS head on. So all these things has shaken the trust, not only Saudi Arabia, but the whole Arab world really in the Obama administration. But I believe there's a good chance right now to prove to the Arab world and the Islamic world and the whole world in general that Obama is willing to follow up and follow through with his words right now to really eradicate and demolish completely ISIS, even if it's going to take 3-4 years to use his own words.